Our next speaker is Dr. M.S. Kiran. Actually, he did his postdoctoral work in biochemistry in Japan, and he worked there for almost 3 years, and he came back to CLRI. And he is actually very, he is specialized in the biochemical to biochemistry. And he'll be talking about programmed cell death, how it is happening, how the, when cancer happens, people are using a lot of therapies and how they are killing the cancerous cells and other stuff. But he is going to give some little knowledge about the programmed cell death. Kiran.
Yeah, thank you. See, before going to my talk, I want to know how many people are interested to go into science field. Because as our director was asking and even deputy commissioner was asking today, most of them, one, two, so many are there, nice. So nobody is interested in engineering and medicine. Fine, huh? Medicine, yeah. It's happy to see that more numbers of students are here interested in doing science, because when we conducted for KVCLRA, most of them wanted engineering and medicine. So happy to see here. So I'll be talking on programmed cell death or apoptosis. Have you heard about this? Anytime? Anywhere? No. Now what happens if you die? No, what happens when we die? Or if, for example, if I die, what happens? No. I am dying and I am lying here. What happened? Nobody is taking and digging me and putting me in some... what happened? We will decay. So what happens when cell die? What happens if cell die like that and it is left unattended? Fine. What happens if it is left unattended? The cells are dying and is left unattended. It will affect the other cells. It will start decaying. So we have a system in our body where when the cells are dying, it should be properly removed from our system, which should not affect our other cells. So how it is happening? The process that is happening is known as apoptosis or programmed cell death. There is another type of cell death also known as necrosis. That is, if somebody hits you, he's hitting you. So you see that next day morning you'll have a dark spot on your hand. So that trauma that is coming like that, the cells are affected in that way, that is known as necrosis. That happens, but usually in our system, it happens by a programmed cell death. Now, how this programmed cell death happens, that I'll describe. See, we have mitochondria. We have endoplasmic reticulum, vacuoles, Golgi body, all these things are there. Now what happens? When a cell is under stress, the cell itself will give a signal to the mitochondria to stop its function. And mitochondria is what is the function of mitochondria? It's a powerhouse. It generates energy and it generates ATP. So what happened is, when we have this cell is under stress, the cell signals to these mitochondria and mitochondrial function stops and pore formation happens, mitochondria enlarge and stops its function. Automatically what happens is, when the powerhouse is stopped, these cells senses that it should undergo death. So what happens is, the nucleus will get enlarged, the cells will form blobs like this. Nuclear condensation happens. Then this is the next stage. Cells blobs forms, the nuclear condensation happens. Then what happens is, this nucleus will disintegrate and small vacuoles will be formed, which will be phagocytosed by the macrophages. Understood? So no trial of that cells will be allowed. And once this process starts, nobody can stop it. That cells will die, whatever be the stage. Now, this process is known as intrinsic way of programmed cell death. Within the cell itself, the cell is giving a signal to die because it is stressed. Now, another condition where that happens is via extrinsic signal. Extrinsic signal is nothing. For example, you are affected by a microorganism or a virus. What are virus? Any idea? Huh? They cannot be considered as living or non-living. They have only a small fragment of DNA or RNA with them and a protein code. What that does is that will, if when it comes to our DNA, it will integrate into our system and uses our own machinery to produce its own amplification, and it will produce its own coat that is known as bacteria. That this thing coating is there. That coat is formed and then it will start affecting our system and leaves. And when the system is outside, it is going, it will die. So our system is having a very strong mechanism to stop it. So when a virus is affecting you and that is integrating into your system, the cell senses that while it is replicating. Replication, any idea? Replication is nothing but division of a cells, where the cells divide into two and the DNA, that is a nuclear hereditary material, will separate into two. Understand? Yeah, right. Our machinery has so strong enzymes and system that it codes like we have DNA. Any idea about nitrogenous bases? Any idea? Yeah, we have four amine bases. What is DNA? Good. Deoxyribonucleic acid. Why? What is the importance of that? It dictates how and what and when, how you look like. For example, a person is having a straight hair. Another person is having a curly hair. See, among you itself, you are saying some people are having beard and some have not come. Why? It's all because of the DNA. At correct time, it will give the appropriate signal and protein, and then automatically our system will change according to that. So that is very important, and that carries that information. Whatever traits you have, that will be carried to your son or daughter. Understood? So what happens is when this virus is integrated into the system, that cell senses that, and automatically that associated cells will, that is one way of intrinsic cell death, so that the cell will undergo death. Second way is extrinsic cell stress, where you have another cell where that will give a signal that senses that the other cell is affected. For example, you have two cells here. You have two cells here. One cell is here, another cell is here. See, this cell is getting infected with the stress or a microorganism. What happens is, this cell will sense that this is getting affected. So this has to be removed from the system. Automatically what happens is, it will give a signal to this thing. A protein is expressed from this system that will go and bind to the death ligand, and that ligand will ask these cells to undergo apoptosis. That is an interplay of so many proteins that finally leads to the death of these cells. Now, what is the importance of apoptosis? Any idea? In physiological condition also, we require that. Any idea? During immune system response, we require that. It's a correct answer. Fine. Next one. During development, when we are in our womb of our mother, our hands will have connections. It is interdigital. We have if you see frog's hand, no. Same way we have our, this thing is connected by a small layer of skin. So while development, there has to be removed from the system. That during that process, that will the apoptosis is involved. And second thing is, it sees that the cells are perfectly functioning well. Now, what is cancer? How? Overgrowth of the cell, because that will lose the function of dying. So we have pro-apoptotic and anti-apoptotic proteins. When we have a anti-apoptotic protein expressed, like BCL2 system, in cancer what happens is the cell starts producing, it's a gain of function, starts producing more amount of BCL, it's a protein, you don't worry about the name and other things. What happens is the system automatically generates this protein, and the cell starts dividing like anything. Usually, lifespan of a cell is how much? How many times? How many times a cell will divide? It will divide approximately 60 to 70 times. Why? Because we have telomeres in the DNA, each time the cell is dividing, small part of the telomere is lost. So after 60th time, there will not be any telomere, so that the enzymes cannot go run completely and the cell will stop growth. Whereas when you, then the cancer cell gains the function, that BCL will be producing and that problem is not there. Automatically with the default machinery, it will be starting to divide and multiply like anything. So strategy to control this cancer is by developing molecules that can promote apoptosis in these cells. So that is one strategy that has been demonstrated, how to bring down this cancer. Understood. I have a few slides which I have prepared. I'll show you how it looks. And I cannot bring a fluorescent microscope here. So still we can identify the morphological changes that is happening in the cells. See, this is cells are stained with hematoxylin. Here you see, nucleus are stained with hematoxylin. Now what you will see here is, see, there is significant, we have treated these cancer cells with a compound that will induce apoptosis. Now what you are seeing is, what are the differences? See, here the nucleus has come out. This is a cell. This nucleus has come out, condensed, and you are seeing fragmentation of this thing. Cytoplasm and other material, nuclear fragmentation happening. Very clearly you can see different stages are there. Here is one cell that is undergoing division. Here you see the cells, nuclear gets, is going to burst and forms vacuoles, and automatically it will be taken up by the cells. And here also is a clear cut indication how that is undergoing. These are the cells which are going for apoptosis. Here you see there is no nucleus. See, automatically it has disintegrated and fragmented. Now it will be taken up by the macrophages and removed from the system. Now, how this process happens? Who controls this process? Enzymes are produced from? In cells by what mechanism? Enzymes are produced from? See, you said that DNA is a genetic material. You have genetic material, DNA. DNA consists of? What is this? Fine. So it will base pair with the? This is what is DNA. Correct? Now, nitrogenous bases together forms a codon. One codon will code for a amino acid. Like that, you have, when this process of transcription, don't worry about that, is formed, that will code for the protein. Like we have methionine will come, then we'll have serine, like that, it will go like that, and a protein is formed. So that the DNA has all the necessary requirement for production of any protein it is having. So what are the types of cells you have in the system? Somatic and gametic cells, correct. So gametic cells divide by? Meiosis. Reduction, directed division. And somatic will divide by? How? No. Mitosis will by? They'll replicate into? Two cells. Otherwise, it is replicating into four cells. So what happens is, during gametic cells, it is in end stage, and you have end stage of nucleus in haploid state in a sperm, and in a haploid state in an ovum. While fertilization, n plus n will form 2n, then it will divide into then undergo mitosis and divide into that. And that stage where it is formed in two stages known as a stem cell or a pluripotent cell, where the whole DNA has all the region active for expression of proteins. With time, they will differentiate into different cell type and where that productivity will come down. There is a special mechanism about that, how that is done. Don't need to worry about that. It's a different concept. Now, what I'm stressing here is the importance of DNA. See, what is the importance of DNA? I want to stress here because it is a genetic material, because whatever the feature is there in the parent, mother and father, 50% will be coming to the offspring. Correct. Other than that, it is another one function. What is that? Yeah, it produces a sufficient amount of protein at correct time and correct this thing. Another this thing is there. No, that's a different protein and enzyme. So that is this thing. So what here is, see, N, this will produce all the proteins required for the growth of an organism. It can control a defective cell. Second thing, that is apoptosis. When a cell is stressed and when nuclear material is affected, the cells itself will sense and undergo apoptosis. So that is another function that is endowed in the DNA. Now, there are various methods for identifying this apoptosis. As mentioned that in the booklet, one is a morphological change which I have shown here. Another one is DNA fragmentation. What is that assay is, you have this cell, no? This cell I will take, then extract the DNA and run an agarose gel. What happens is, if the cells are undergoing apoptosis, you'll have fragments of DNA coming. So many bands will be coming. Whereas an intact cell will have only a single band. The genomic DNA will be in a single band. Another method of doing that is by fluorescence, as Ishwar said, it's via fluorescence dye, where we use acridine and propidium iodide. There are two dyes that is used for seeing. When if it is a live cell, it will stain green in color. Where if the cells are undergoing death, it will stain orange or red, yellowish orange or red, depending upon the late or early apoptotic phase. I will show some images of that also, which I have captured. Normal cell. When you culture a cell, it appears like this. See how beautiful it is. There is no change in this morphology and any features. Whereas, when you are treating it with apoptotic agent, cells undergo death. Now you see the morphological difference. But see, it's now very clear. Now you see how the cells have formed bloods and how the vacuole formations are there, and then it disintegrating, and if we have a macrophage in the system, they will take up. So that the cells will not get, other cells will not get affected. Same way, you can see the different features that is having condensation. Each process can be identified from this. Now, when you stain this normal cells with this apoptotic propidium iodine, this stain, it stains green, that indicating the cells are viable. Whereas when you treat this is an apoptotic cell, when you stain with propidium iodine, you will have yellowish color. This is indicating of an early apoptotic stage, where you have a red color indicating that the cells are undergoing a late apoptotic phase. So this is very much important with reference to cancer, and any compound that can be developed to induce apoptosis in cancer can be a potential therapeutic target. But that many people have developed that, but later on they have found that it is not working. Why? Because cancer, we have two sets of cells. Cancer is a mass like this. We have cells that are in the interior core and we have cells in the outer core. So only when agents will affect this area, it is very difficult to reach this part of the cancer. So automatically it will again grow. So now they are targeting on angiogenesis. That part will be dealt in the next time when if we come for a talk. And I also wish that we are conducting a residential program at CLRI. If anybody is interested, you can come there, where we will show you and hands on how this can be done. Even fragmentation of that can be taught to you. Because it's very difficult in carrying all those big, big instruments. That is why we have not done that. So light microscopic images are done by staining it with hematopsis. So any clarification required? Any questions? Anybody else? Starting stage, we can remove that when, because cancer, if it is in localized to one area, you can treat it in an initial stage, it's a small mass. So then we can remove straight down, it can be removed. So what happens is in most of the cancers, undergo metastasis. So you have a cancer in the lungs, one small cell will come out, it will again go into the circulation, that will go and stick to some other area, and it will start growing there. So that area will be also getting affected. Now why this can't be cured is, I told you, you have inner core, you have outer core. After 1 millimeter of growth, what happens is, this, the inner core is highly in the under hypoxic condition, less oxygen is there. So what happens is, cells will start producing growth factors and start secreting nucleic acidic microenvironment. That will leads to the formation of blood vessels. From the pre-existing vessel, we have the blood vessels going to the cancer. Once that area is vascularized, no, then it is very difficult to kill. So people are trying to identify molecules that can stop angiogenesis. Still, more drug has been identified that can go directly into the internal core region of the cancer cells. So always, the only peripheral region will be cured. Inside core will still remain like the necrotic region. So automatically, they will be producing more growth factor, and again, it will be cured. So it's very difficult to find a cure for that.
That that cannot be generalized. See, cancer, some people may do that, some people may not do that. See, that depending upon which type of cancer you have. If you have a lung cancer and this throat infection, chances of blood vomiting is very high. Whereas some other cancers and all will not have this thing. For example, you have breast cancer, only the that breast will get burst out and then infection will come and then that will happen. It is not necessary. And also, when you give treatment, chemotherapy, chances of this can be seen. It is not that it is essential that blood should be vomited by a cancer patient. Any other clarification? Both chemotherapy is there, also radiation also will be induced. So that what happens is, you give a radiation to a, you have a drug or a molecule that will specifically go and bind to the cancer cells. You have cancer, assume that you have cancer. They will give a, the chemotherapy is like that. You specifically target to the cancer cell, there they will accumulate there in the cancer cells and they irradiate that with the ionizing radiation. Ionizing radiation what happens is, specifically generate redox and ionizing condition in the cell's microenvironment, automatically the cells will undergo death. But still, same features can be seen. But still, the problem is, no, the internal core mass cannot be cure completely removed in cancers. That is why we cannot get a complete cure for that. And even a metastatic condition, if it, we don't know, even a single cell peeling off from the cancer mass and going and binding somewhere else, we will not know. See, in a later stage, you know that, okay, from the lungs, it has come to your bone. So you will have bone or another part of the body. So that is a problem with the cancer. And only way that you can do is healthy lifestyle and reduce these, because our lifestyle is one of the reason why we have gaining all this kind of occupation. It's a kind of a lifestyle disorder only, cancer also. Earlier, it is incidents were very low. Now, because of the junk food and all, automatically we are prone to all this kind of mutation and things where we'll gain of function or loss of function and let automatically lead to cancer. So I think, I don't know how much you have grasped what I've conveyed, but in more details we'll be telling you in a, because short time like we'll not be able to cover in a long way. So I think better if anybody is interested, you can come for the residential program. That time we can study in detail.